To know more such amazing stories from Indian history, click the bell icon and subscribe to Live History India.
This historic temple in Panhala Fort near Kolhapur is one of the most unique temples in Maharashtra. This temple is not dedicated to any Hindu god, but to a Maratha ruler, Chhatrapati Sambhaji II of Kolhapur. Due to its name, many erroneously believe that this is a temple dedicated to the famous Maratha hero, Chhatrapati Sambhaji Maharaj, the eldest son of Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj, who was cruelly put to death on orders of Emperor Aurangzeb in 1689. But this Chhatrapati is different. Chhatrapati Sambhaji II of Kolhapur, better known as Karveer Sambhaji, was the second son of Chhatrapati Rajaram and nephew of the famous Chhatrapati Sambhaji Maharaj. Sambhaji II ruled between 1712 and 1760. The famous Panhala Fort, located just 20 kilometers from the city of Kolhapur, was one of the most important forts in the Maratha Kingdom, as it dominated the strategic trade routes to Konkan and South India. In 1689, Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj's younger son, Chhatrapati Sambhaji Maharaj, was put to death on orders of Emperor Aurangzeb. Raigad was captured by the Mughal army, and Chhatrapati Sambhaji Maharaj's son, Shahu, was taken as a prisoner to Delhi with his mother, Yesubai. Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj's younger son, Rajaram, along with his wives Tarabai and Rajasbai, escaped to Panhala and later to Gingee. During his absence, the Maratha kingdom was ruled by his minister Ramchandra Pant Amatya, famous as Hukumat Panah, whose Samadhi lies just opposite the temple of Sambhaji II at Panhala. While Rajaram returned to Maharashtra and died soon after in 1700 CE, the reins of the administration was taken up by his elder queen Tarabai on behalf of her son Shivaji II. Tarabai, who was famous for her wars with the Mughals, kept Rajaram's younger queen Rajasbai and her son Sambhaji II as prisoners in the Panhala fort. But the powerful and ambitious Tarabai had made a lot of enemies in the Maratha court. And one day in 1714, a palace coup took place at Panhala. Tarabai and her son Shivaji II were deposed from power, and Sambhaji II came on Kolhapur's throne. Unlike his stepbrother, Sambhaji II of Kolhapur was an extremely powerful and ambitious ruler. During this time, the Marathas had been involved in a bitter civil war, with one side supporting Sambhaji II of Kolhapur and the other side supporting his cousin, Shahu of Satara. A lot of battles took place between the two sides, but the war was inconclusive. While Shahu had Peshwa Bajirao I, the great general in India at that time, on his side, Sambhaji II formed an alliance with the Nizam of Hyderabad. After years and years of bloodshed, the two cousins decided to end their war by signing the Treaty of Varna in 1731, as per which anything north of the Varna River belonged to Shahu, while lands to the south belonged to Sambhaji II. This led to the formation of the princely state of Kolhapur, and interestingly, even today, the boundary of Kolhapur district begins at Varna River. Following the treaty, Sambhaji II ruled his kingdom peacefully till his demise in 1760. After his death, this unique temple was built on the place where he was cremated. Built in traditional Maratha style, the temple is made of black basalt. Even today, Sambhaji II is worshipped here as deity, quite a unique tradition. Sadly, Most visitors to the Panhala give this temple a miss, preferring to visit more popular attractions like the famous Teen Darwaza and the Andhar Baudi. It is hoped that this unique and historic temple is given its due as well.